Assalamu alaikum, this is Salman with one more video on my channel. Today's my video is about configuration of TP-Link WA901 NT wireless access point. This access point it can give up to 450 Mbps speeds over wireless internet connection. So let's go and configure it. So by default, when you purchase a new TP-Link router, this router comes with default IP 192.168.0.254. So you have to enter this IP address in your browser, and then your browser will display a login page. By default, password is admin and username is also admin. So let's click it. Okay, here we go. So whenever we are configuring this for the first time, it's showing us quick setup. So if you want very easy setup, you can go through it, and if you don't want to go through this one, and if you are little bit expert and you can do configuration of your own, so you can click exit and leave it. So first of all, I will configure this with quick setup, so click the next. Here it will ask us change login account. In case if you want to change your admin password and user ID for login to this access point for configuration, then you should click yes. It will ask you the old username, old password, new username and new password, and then repeat the new password. So for the time being, I'm clicking it no and next. Here it's going to ask us access point mode, repeater mode, bridge with AP, client, multi SSID. So these are the multiple modes that this access point can handle. So we can select whatever we want. So right now I'm going to select it with access point mode because for that reason I have purchased this. So click next. Here is the SSID. You can say in simple words your Wi-Fi name that will display on your mobile screen and laptops or whatever device you have. So by default, this access point have TP-Link AP3494, so you can set it up. I will keep it complex. Channel, better to keep it auto. It will detect automatically surrounding areas and filter the channel usage in your area, and then it can automatically set whatever channel is best for your access point. So here is a password, Wi-Fi password, you can say in simple words. Let's suppose 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. So next, and here is the DHCP server. If you want to enable it or disable it, right now this option is non-selectable because our router is not connected with any network, so there is no any DHCP server found on this network, so automatically this is going to be disabled, enabled. So it will give automatically IP addresses to our clients that are connected right now. So if there is any LAN connection or any other DHCP server on this network, and this device automatically gets IP address for its incoming port, then it will automatically disable this DHCP server. So let's click to next, and here is the summary of our all configurations. Wireless setting, operation mode as access point, Wi-Fi name, SSID is Comtrix, channel auto, YP secure, wireless security mode, this is WPA/WPA2PSK, and the password is 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. So network setting, right now this is TP-Link AP.net. you can type in your browser and then it can automatically come up with the login page. And also, if you want to access this router page with the IP address, then you can type this IP address 192.168.0.254. So let's finish it, and here we go. Okay, so after finishing these all installations, this is our first page that is status page. It will show the all status. So this is the firmware version, hardware version, in case if you are going to upgrade in futures any newly released firmware from TP-Link, then this information would be much more helpful. So this page, it will automatically refresh because definitely for the status it will get, so it will refresh automatically. So here it show wide connection, IP address is 0.254, and this is a MAC address, subnet mask, and wireless operation mode is access point, and all other things that we have configured right now, these are here. So this is the uptime, 17 minutes 28 seconds. Here's again quick setup mode. If you want to configure it manually, so you can configure it. So this is WPS mode, so if you want to disable it, you can disable. If you want to enable it, then it's also possible to enable. This network option, this is used for configuring your LAN port. In case if you are going to bound any IP address with this MAC address, so then you should know this MAC address. Otherwise, you can also set up the static IP address for your router. So better to leave it for the smart IP, DHCP, you can say. DHCP setting, in this case you can enable DHCP or disable. So right now, because there is no any kind of DHCP server find on the network, so it is automatically giving IP addresses to the clients that are connecting to this router, this Wi-Fi access point, sorry. So here you can see these are the devices that are right now connected. This is a blue star, MAC address, uptime, and the assigned IP address. So here we go for the wireless. These are the modes. Later on we can change from here also, multi SSID. Here we can set up multiple access IDs. This access point supports up to 4 different SSIDs. So I will go with one only. Okay, so channel, all thing that we have checked there. This is Wi-Fi password. If you want to change your password, so you can change from here. And MAC filtering, this is very interesting feature. In case anybody knows your password and you don't want to change your password also, and nowadays there are a lot of application then can that can hack your passwords, so better to enable this option and put your MAC addresses and give them allow option and new. Here you can enter the MAC address, and here you can enter the MAC address name just for description for your Wi-Fi, and then you can select enable. So when you are going to enter the MAC address and you are going to allow these from this option, then it will allow only the addresses that are entered in this MAC address list. Otherwise, no any kind of device or laptop or mobile will be able to connect, even if they know password also. So I will keep it disabled for the time being. I do not need this. Wi-Fi advanced. These are transmit power. You can set up middle, low, only that is useful. Wireless statistics. And throughput monitor. You can click start here and it will show you what is the actual usage of wireless parameters, wireless bandwidth. So one more thing here, if you click enable SSID broadcast, then it will show the Wi-Fi name on your mobile phones and laptops, and if you disable this one, then it will not show you Wi-Fi name on your mobile screens. Here we go, SNMP diagnostics, ping watchdog, firmware update, factory defaults. This is useful when you are going to set the router to default setting. Backup and restore, when you want to take the backup of your setting, in case if you have lost your setting and your router is totally up to factory reset, so then you can select the backup file and then restore this router back to that setting. Reboot, you can reboot easily from here. password, you can change password from here also. Signal, sorry, system log. This is system log that you can check from here, all the system logs. Mail settings also here. If you want to configure email, so it can give you email options also. Okay guys, this is all that we have in this tippling WA901ND router, sorry, Wi-Fi access point. So that's it for right now. Thank you, take care, bye bye.